Shapley. Oh, wow. The big one. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, UFC 263 main event. The main event itself. It was a fun night. There was fantastic fights. Easy went out there, put in a striking clinic, and some showed that Yan taking him down was just that night. Easy always improves after a loss. That's what he says. And we saw that Vittori tried to play Yan, but apparently he's just Vittori. So wow, fantastic fight. Quick, I'll start with you, Mayowa. What do you think about Easy's performance?
There's nothing there. There's nothing new. Mm-hmm. Are you guys surprised? I knew it was going to be like that. Mm-hmm. I mean, the only thing I respect Vittori for not getting knocked out. It's very tough. Mm-hmm. And there's a combination that we use all the time. Mm-hmm. I keep saying we Easy. There's a combination Easy uses all the time. The 1-2 that he used to knock out Costa and Whittaker. Mm-hmm. Vittori read that combination very well. So shout respect to him.
True. I saw that. I stayed there as well.
Easy carried like 4 or 5 times. They read it. So respect. But there's nothing surprising there. Easy is the best in the world. We know he's the best. Those guys don't have anything for him. Like, we knew coming in. And it's funny because the fight was the same way the first fight went, just longer. And Vittori still thinks he won the fight because...
Don't worry. We'll get there. You
know, there's nothing new.
I asked you how Easy's performance was. Over to you, Farouk. But please, Farouk, try to be positive. How did you see Vittori's performance?
Not bad. Vittori did well. Mm. Did well because let's give him, like Mario has the credit to Vittori. The guy is durable. He's strong. He came in heavier, trying to use the Yan game plan as well, going for a takedown. But Easy was not there to be taken down last night. So he did well overall. Mm. And you talk about the 1-2 combination by Easy. Like Vittori read that clearly, and even the head kick.
Yeah,
even the head kick, he took some great head kick when he was still there coming forward. And also his leg was badly hurt. He didn't take his leg throughout the fights, man. He didn't check the leg kick. I would say Vittori, shout out to Vittori. He did well, but at some point in time, it's just like the class between him and Israel this side is just two different class. Israel is just way ahead of Vittori. So because he came with one game plan, he could not change the game plan. So that's where he messed up the whole thing. But
you know what the funniest
credit
part
to him
about
for staying through the whole fight, for not getting knocked out, because I predicted a KO in the third round, just like Usman did, and Mayowa did, but it didn't happen there. But still, a beautiful performance by Easy. Great win.
What I saw was the mastery in feints. We already knew about Easy's feints coming into this fight, but whenever he feints, it maybe faints from the bottom or going to the top, or from the top going to the down. If you see how Vittori freezes, you understand? It's like there's a remote control that is pausing him. You understand? Whenever you see him flinch, he freezes this way, he freezes that way. And me watching, it was hard for me to watch. Like, because in my head, I'll be like, okay, what would I do if I was like Vittori? Because sometimes when the fight is going on, I'll be like trying to like, because fight fans, you understand, when you're watching fights, sometimes you get lost into it. So I was kind of like freezing with Vittori too, because I was thinking that when Easy faints, it gets to me too, because I always think that he's going to land. But anyways, that's why I have to say, beautiful, beautiful striking display by our boy Easy.
They're just on two different class, man. Look at Easy head movement, his defense.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the wrestling, the takedown defense as well. Mm. Vittori could not do anything. He was easy to take a break, man. He was just staying there, it was like
Vittori was like on an island, you know. He's going for takedowns, but the takedowns are not there. But then he doesn't want to strike too, because the striking, he's not winning. So what he's going to do? He's just going to clinch and stay there. I mean, let me just take these elbows. That is
he was tired. He was trying to rest. In the clinch, he was tired. There was one big feint in the fight that Easy did, that the boy jumped and he almost fell down. I said, oh, what a shame. Listen, it's funny because I was commenting, if you're going to check my Instagram comments the whole week, I was just commenting when they did the face-ups. Hmm. I said, this boy is already biting feints in the face-up. Like, he was in trouble. Like, he was biting every single thing. It was bad. But shout out to him, he's very, he's a strong guy. He's a strong guy. Oh, yeah, he took the shot very well.
What about talking about his coach? His coaches. I felt you were just hyping that guy.
His coach was telling him the truth. And he did. No, the truth, I know. Rafael Caldera was losing, losing his fight. Tried to
he told him, round one. I watched the first round and I was thinking maybe the takedown, the first round takedown after he caught Izzy's low kick. I thought maybe that would play something in the judge's head, right? But then, apart from that, there was zero offense. All the strikes that landed was from Izzy. Even when he got the takedown, he couldn't land anything. You understand? So when he went to the corner and the coach told him, you lost that round, I was like, did he actually lose that round? And they showed the replays. I was like, I kind of think he actually did
but,
lose that
round. He lost the round.
But you know what?
I agree with the coaches at some point in time. They were giving that guy falsehood. They're not telling him the truth. They told him the truth that he was losing the fight, but they tell him to do something that was unrealistic.
How?
He cannot get into the fight. His leg is damaged. He cannot exchange with Izzy.
His coach told him you cannot stand with Izzy. You're losing the standing battle. You need to rest constantly. That's what he told him every time.
Yeah, I know.
Cordero was telling the guy, please rest. Go forward, take him down. Rest. You cannot stand up. And
but the takedown was not there.
Well, he was clueless.
He didn't know what to do because all they said to him, he could not implement anything going back into the next round.
He was fighting with his own coach. You guys saw the clips this week. He wasn't listening to the coach. In fact, there's jokes that they're making that a guy may fire his coach because the coach was telling him and he wasn't listening. Because he's so stubborn. That's why he thinks he still wants
to fight. I think even the first round,
he's a meathead.
The commentary was saying, the coach say you lost the first round. No, what he said to the coaches, according to what I heard on the commentary, that about I dominated the fight. He was arguing with his coach that he dominated the fight.
So it's nothing hidden that Vittori has Donald Trump mentality. That is we never take defeat no matter how lopsided it is. Because even after the fight, Vittori was saying that he won the fight, guys.
Do you see his face when he called the scorecard? You see his face.
He actually thought he was going to win because when the ref was holding both hands, my guy was still campaigning,
lifting
like,
his hand up.
Like I'm.
He was surprised when he lost. Like it was the same face he did in first fight.
The guy is delusional. That's the honest truth.
How did I lose?
I honestly think. Maybe is the moment that is making him think like that. Probably when he sits down and rewatch the fight, he would accept. But I think he's too stubborn. You know he would never publicly accept that he lost the fight.
That's not the moment. Yeah, he doesn't want to accept. And he was kind of, you know, when you know you messed up and you are shy. How do I accept defeat now in front of everybody?
Well, you know
that. Oh. Yes. I want
sorry to talk over you, but you know there are people like that no matter what, they never accept defeat. You understand? They never accept defeat. They would see the reality, but they would not accept it. It did not happen. You guys can say what you want to say. It did not happen. That's the type of mentality he has.
When I used to play FIFA, I stopped playing FIFA now because they beat me too much. I had my cousin, let's meet my cousin, and he would beat me. I would say, no, let's play again. He would beat me 10 times. He can beat me 5-0, 2-0, 3-0. Mm. I would say, let's keep playing. I must beat you. And that's how Vittori is. I realized you can beat him, keep beating him. You say, no, let's keep fighting until I win. That's the kind of guy he doesn't accept that you're beating him until he can find his own way to win.
But guys, I think that
may be his downfall. He needs to learn to accept and now go back to drawing board. Easy when he lost to Yan. That fight can be even a draw. Easy fight. It was split decision victory.
It was unanimous because of the tennis.
They
even gave you a 1 tennis, which is crazy.
Mm. Yes. But that fight can even be a draw. That's what they call a close fight. But Izzy accepted defeat, said I made some mistakes. I'm going to readjust. But Vittori is not learning from all the situation.
Farouk, I don't think he can come and sit down and be like, I'll start taking defeats when I get defeated. I feel like it is his character as a person. He's someone that no matter what, even if it's in fighting or anything in life, he would never accept defeat. There are stubborn people like that. There are many, many stubborn people. But that does not take the fact away. That does not take the fact away that he's a good fighter. You understand?
Yeah.
And is he at the level of Izzy when it comes to martial arts? No.
No.
And it's very, very obvious. Well, I want to see the fight of crybabies, him and Polo Costa.
You didn't say it well. Want to see the fight of easy exes? Let them fight themselves.
He's an ex because he grabbed his nyasha. Easy grab. Did you guys see when
they fight themselves?
So well, yeah,
Easy is a problematic person.
Yeah. But hey, well, it's settled. We are going to see Easy versus Whittaker.
Whittaker next, yeah.
Yeah, but we are not sure of the location yet. Although Easy said he wanted Auckland, but Dana said that they cannot go to those regions this year. So if Izzy wants to fight this year, they probably would fight. Probably fight with Whittaker, maybe fight Island or
bring it to Lagos, Nigeria. What are they doing? Bring us to Lagos, Nigeria.
We'll get to that. We'll get to that. All right, guys. moving on. Come on, Africans.